Dizziness is a sensation that can be challenging to articulate, often characterized by a feeling of spinning, swaying, tilting, or an impending sensation of falling or fainting. Additionally, dizziness may manifest as lightheadedness, a sense of giddiness, or difficulty maintaining a straight walking path. Vertigo is a prevalent form of dizziness. When experiencing vertigo, individuals may perceive themselves or their surroundings as in motion, even when they are stationary. Vertigo can arise from various issues related to the inner ear or the brain. Individuals experiencing vertigo may encounter sensations such as a spinning sensation or a perception that the environment is spinning around them, sensations of tilting or swaying, a feeling of being off balance. These sensations can be episodic, varying in duration from seconds to minutes, hours, or even days. Certain movements, changes in position, e.g., standing up or turning in bed, coughing or sneezing, may exacerbate these feelings. Depending on the underlying cause of vertigo, additional symptoms might accompany it, including nausea or vomiting, headaches or heightened sensitivity to light and noise, double vision, speech or swallowing difficulties, or muscle weakness, shortness of breath, perspiration, or an accelerated heart rate. Vertigo typically arises when there is an issue within the vestibular system, a crucial component responsible for maintaining balance. This system encompasses segments of both the inner ear and the nervous system. Various conditions can impact the vestibular system, with some being non-serious while others can pose life-threatening risks. Benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, BPPV. BPPV, also known as benign positional vertigo or simply vertigo, is a term used to describe vertigo resulting from the displacement of calcium deposits within the inner ear. Episodes of vertigo in individuals with BPPV are typically short-lived, lasting only a few seconds to less than a minute. Certain head movements can trigger these episodes. BPPV often resolves spontaneously, but can also be effectively treated through a procedure known as canalith repositioning. This procedure, also called the Epley maneuver, is administered by a healthcare professional in an office setting. By carefully positioning your head, this maneuver encourages the relocation of calcium deposits, referred to as canaliths, to a region of the inner ear where they can be reabsorbed. Improvement in symptoms can occur immediately or within a day or two following treatment. If the treatment proves successful, you may receive instructions on how to perform similar movements at home should your symptoms recur. Meniere's disease, a chronic condition believed to be associated with an accumulation of fluid in the inner ear, is characterized by recurring bouts of vertigo accompanied by hearing impairment, tinnitus, ringing in the ear, and a sensation of ear fullness. Typically, these symptoms impact one ear, with episodes lasting for varying durations, sometimes extending to several minutes or hours. Vertigo often brings along nausea and vomiting, and a lingering unsteadiness may persist for days after an episode. Although Meniere's disease is a lifelong ailment, non-surgical treatments prove effective in managing symptoms for around 90% of individuals. Vestibular neuritis, alternatively known as labyrinthitis, is believed to be associated with a viral infection that triggers inflammation around the nerve responsible for balance. Individuals afflicted by vestibular neuritis experience abrupt and intense vertigo, accompanied by nausea, vomiting, and challenges in walking or maintaining an upright posture. In certain cases, there may also be hearing loss in one ear. Typically, these symptoms persist for several days before gradually resolving, though some individuals may continue to experience lingering dizziness or balance issues lasting for several months. It's important to note that hearing loss in some cases may be permanent. Vestibular migraine can be a trigger for bouts of vertigo. While not everyone affected experiences typical migraine headaches, many do, along with additional migraine symptoms like visual auras or heightened sensitivity to light. These migraine-related symptoms can either coincide with the vertigo episodes or manifest independently. The duration of the vertigo episodes varies, with most lasting several minutes to a few hours. Vertigo treatment depends on the underlying cause. Healthcare providers use a variety of treatments, which may include repositioning maneuvers, vertigo medication, vestibular rehabilitation therapy, vertigo exercises, surgery. Canalith repositioning procedures, such as the Epley maneuver, can assist in repositioning crystals within your semicircular canals back into the utricle. These maneuvers entail a sequence of specific head movements and can be administered by a healthcare professional during an office visit or taught for at-home use. In cases of acute, sudden onset, short duration, vertigo, medication may offer relief. Healthcare providers may suggest motion sickness medications like meclizine or dimenhydrinate, as well as antihistamines such as cyclizine to alleviate vertigo symptoms. Vestibular rehabilitation therapy focuses on exercises aimed at improving common vertigo symptoms like dizziness, unsteady vision, and balance issues. These exercises may encompass stretching, strengthening, controlling eye movements, and even simple activities like marching in place. Though uncommon, surgery may be necessary when a serious underlying health condition, such as a brain tumor or neck injury, is the root cause of vertigo. Typically, surgery is considered when other treatments have proven ineffective.